एंड कंटेंट हैज बीन वन ऑफ द और म्यूजिक वीडियोज ऑल काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स हैज बीन वन ऑफ द स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट सुइट्स फॉर आईपैड. मोस्ट ऑफ अस नो दैट दे हैव अ लार्ज नंबर ऑफ एप्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इवन फॉर द आईपैड इटसेल्फ देर आर प्रॉब्ली 100,000 प्लस एप्स. वाइल आई थिंक बियॉन्ड अ सर्टेन पॉइंट द नंबर्स स्टार्ट बिकमिंग लेस एंड लेस रेलिवेंट. अमॉन्ग्स दैट ह्यूज नंबर देर आर सर्टेनली की मार्की एप्स which you don't find on other platforms and which are very useful apps, which are very good apps, apps like Flipboard, Zite, which at least personally I use a lot for to kind of consume content of all kinds. What you may not know is Apple has also gone to great pains to kind of have strong parental controls in place so that when I give this device to my daughter or to a kid, I can set this up in a way very easily. So that I am rest assured that all kinds of random content is not reaching into the hands of a child. Again, things like featured apps, staff choices, all kinds of different categories. Apple has been doing this for a while, so I think they have gotten very good at it. Usually, whenever I need to find something, it's fairly easy to go into a category, look at the featured apps, and start browsing from there and find the right app that I'm looking for. With the number of users. There is a good number of ratings and reviews that you can rely on. So I guess from all that perspective, the app store as well as the music store is really something real very useful on the iPad.
The apps, right? Currently, is it only the kind of apps
I don't think so. I think there is a fairly good categorization. That's what I use mostly. That let's say I want to use entertainment apps or find entertainment apps or productivity apps or business apps. I drill down in that manner, not necessarily through voice. But if you search on voice, for example, you will get a fair number of relevant apps. Which may not have everything that you are looking for, but will be a good starting point for you to find what you really want to get.
When they upload the app, don't they tag certain keywords that might be related to that?
No, so the search is strong on name, on category, and then description overall. They don't have this concept of that I'll have too many different tags and so on. But having said that, and then personally, I have found that it works reasonably well on those parameters.
You mentioned the web apps being used in iPad, right?
They are not available to download from the app store on the device. Fundamentally, a web app, you can add it yourself. You go to a website, you go to the browser, and there is the place where you say that I want to add a bookmark. Some of the other options you see, one is add to reading list, which I was talking about a little earlier, that you want to read it later. The other is add to home screen. This is what really adds it as a web app on the home screen itself.
It is no different than a bookmark, except that it will present on your home screen.
So two differences. One, it is on the home screen. Two, when you run this, it's running in its own Safari instance. It's not like a tab within another Safari, within the one Safari. If you go now, if I start this, so it most of these web apps, once you add them, I think it is doing something to the Apple one, but most of these apps, when you add them as most of these web apps, just like any other app, you will see them in the running process list, which is kind of a direct result of the fact that it's running in its own instance. Just to answer his question completely. So even though on App Store you don't have that, if you go to their web app store, there they have a section for web apps, and they do list a fair number of websites which work well as web apps. So you can go there and browse and look for things. Not sure about that. They do have a listing of on their website itself somewhere. They do have this concept. that these are the web apps that you may be interested in. It's just that.
No, so in Android there is a process you need to upload, but there is no approval. So as soon as you upload, it's up to you to go ahead and publish it. Even though I think their team kind of looks at some of the apps based on complaints and they remove it if required. By default, you just upload it and it's available for everyone.
But Amazon being a private app store, it does on its own.
So Amazon has its own app store where it's kind of certifies the app and then only publishes it.
Does Apple also have
the
concept of private app store?
So Apple does not. Apple has its own app store, so it controls that behavior. There is something for enterprises that enterprises can distribute their own applications, but not for consumers. For consumers, they always go to this.
So is your question around that, like for Samsung, they have their own? But in Apple's case, anyway, Apple is the only one who is making these tablets, right? There's no one else who is making this and has an interest to put their own app store. Now, the web apps, yes, so it's fairly easy. Apple.com/web apps does have a fair amount of categorization. They do have staff picks amongst this also. It's just that they don't probably push it as much as the app store, and you don't see it in the normal app store.
Are there any
They have been reasonably guarded about that information. So while you do get some idea that these apps are doing well, they don't give that information out that easily. Only recommend, but even there, there's no guarantee. Usually, what I have seen is sometimes they just have probably some team which is looking at new apps or their library of apps and what they want to highlight, they want people to know about more apps and so on. So they keep changing it. Doesn't necessarily mean that what is featured is something which has been downloaded more or anything like that.
Similar apps, if you do, there it is not by some recommended one.
Yeah, so similar again, I think, is more based on category and some kind of a search match. And I think they do a good job of that. But in across the app store, one theme you will find is there's very little information on how much an app has really sold. As in, you have those top 10 lists, and you can derive with some basic conclusion based on that, that it's probably based on how much revenue it generated or how much downloads there were. But there's no way to sort apps based on that. So beyond the top 10, it starts becoming difficult. Not easy to get to that information.
Like Android, we had monitor app, battery usage, and all.
There are native apps, system monitor. There are apps which let you read logs. There are apps which give you battery performance of certain apps, or overall which app is consuming what battery and so on. So there is a fair number of those as well. It's just that they are not natively added to the, and those are free ones also for the, there are free ones for the most part. It's just that you have to find it and install it. We talked about apps and content. Another category where Apple is trying to make a push is books and magazines. In their newest release of the OS, they added this concept of a newsstand, which is a focused place to keep all the books and magazines which you may buy. Earlier, these things used to be there as a category within the App Store earlier. Even now, if you go, you'll find them. But this lets you have these books and magazines in one focused place. You can't even remove this newsstand from the home screen.
Can you read this offline?
Once you have downloaded it, you can read it offline. Yes.
It's like books, right?
It's like books. I'll show it to you, and I'm downloading it and I'll show it to you. I think besides apps, books, content and so on, the discussion won't probably be complete without talking about iCloud, their push into the whole synchronization and backup capabilities. Steve Jobs himself had said that he wants the hub for a user to move from the PC to a cloud or a Mac to a cloud. And I think iCloud is the next big step on that. It lets you fairly easily sync documents, contacts, photos across devices between your Mac and it's all Apple. So your Mac and your iOS devices and so on will work perfectly well. I think they do have something coming out or which came out for PC as well, which works with iTunes and gives you the same capability on the PC as well. I haven't tried it personally, but when they launched it, they had said that they'll have something for the PC as well. But at least the Mac and the iOS devices, it works fairly well.
Does it need any other app to do that
from
PC?
From PC, it needs something else other than iTunes. That is, I haven't tried it personally. So that's the only thing. What we thought was that we'll, after a discussion around all these different capabilities and so on, we'll round off with a couple of sections around how a tablet is being used at home.